Hello everybody out there on YouTube, and welcome back to more coverage of Season 9 NNSCRA Walmart Cup Series action, as we are set for race number 16 of the season. I am Levi McIntyre, a.k.a. Thrashmaniac99, the voice of NNSCRA Walmart Cup Series, here to welcome you to the Subway Fresh Fit 400 here at Phoenix International Raceway, as we're getting set for 47 laps of racing here at this 1 mile track. And this is the updated version from 2011 when it was first reconfigurated, repaved, and all that good stuff. So this is going to be quite interesting for these drivers to return to a track we haven't been to in quite a few seasons. So before we look at the lineup, let's take a look and see how the point standings look. After last week at Pocono, Johnny Gardner still has the points lead, but by only 6 points now over Trent Dunham. Third is Dylan Young, fourth is Preston Plourd, fifth is DJ Curtis. Sixth is Pichu London, seventh is Dorian Facepuncher, eighth is Katie Cochran, ninth is Michael Norman, and then 10th is Tim Walsh. Rest of the top 20 is Tanner Sullivan, Seth Cole, Austin LaPlante, James McLeod, Charles Sanfer, David Rivera, PJ Williams, Jesse Setti, Matt McIntyre, and Carson Gumm. Drivers on the outside looking into the top 30 in points, the five highest, are Zach Rogers, Kyle Matthews, Stephanie Naylor, Devin Becker, and Kyle Keith. And right now, it is still pretty close between 28th and 33rd. It is now only separated by 31 points between 28th and 33rd. With that area being Dylan Poteet, Jessica Shelton, Chris Washer, Zach Rogers, Kyle Matthews, Stephanie Naylor. As far as in between 30th and 31st, it is separated by 14 points, with Washer in 30th and Rogers in 31st. So it's getting down, once again, like I said, it's getting down to the wire of who can make it in the top 30 and stay there. So this is going to continue on throughout the rest of the season, but let's go ahead and take a look at the starting lineup, as real quick in the last row will be Pichu London, Dylan Poteet. Top 10, Sean Galligan is on the pole for today. Next to him will be Charles Sanfer. Row 2 are two of those drivers in that danger zone in the top 30 and outside the top 30. Chris Washer and Jessica Shelton. Row 3 is Zach Rogers and Nathan Hudson. Row 4 is Preston Plourd and Trent Dunham, and then row 5, Carson Gumm and Blaine Keyes. But let's go ahead and get the command to fire engines for the Subway Fresh Fit 400 at Phoenix.
Is this on? Drivers, start your engines!
Awkward. But anyways, the cars are rolling out of pit road for the pace lap. Now this track, I have a feeling that any line can work as long as you can maintain momentum. But I do think it will be the low line that will probably end up being the preferred line to run. As far as who I'm going to pick for this week, I am going to go with the 3 car of Michael Norman, because he's had some momentum going this season. He currently is 9th in points, despite a rather lackluster run last week at Pocono. He is looking to get his first win this season, and hopes to try to stay in the top 10 for the chase, because after this week, it's 10 races left until the chase, so time will be starting to run out for a lot of people. Pace car into pit road, and it's time to boogity, 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 go racing, boys and girls. Sean Galligan leads the first lap, as he's got fellow Dodge Dart driver but rival team of Tommy Baldwin Racing, Chris Washer, behind. And back here, battle for third is now Zach Rogers with a run to the inside of Charles Sanford. But Sanford actually maintains a bit of a run up the high line. That's what I mean. Any line can work as long as you can maintain momentum. And right there off of turn four, it was the high line that was able to maintain a lot more of the momentum. As Sanford clears the nine of Rogers. Looking on throughout the field, it's pretty much double wide throughout much of the field, and now it was almost three wide for a moment. Dylan Thoreau about got split in the middle, but they managed to keep it all straight and narrow. Battle for third still raging between Charles Sanford and Zach Rogers, as Rogers is going to nearly got the apron, which is legal here. You can use the apron to try to gain a little extra speed. And Zach Rogers trying to get by Charles, but it's like off at four. When you're on the bottom lane, you have to let off a little bit in order to make the corner. Otherwise, if you're running the bottom full speed ahead, you're going to get really tight. And the high line, you're able to... And the high line, you're able to run at full throttle off the corner. So that is how Charles Sanford maintains the high line as far as when this battle keeps on raging. So Chris Washer has just been going back and forth, either losing the lead or gaining the lead on Galligan up in the lead. Seth Cole now running dead last as Pichu London, Dylan Poteet are both trying to find their way more up front in the field, but nothing's really working, as now Rogers is right back to the back bumper again of the 03. And right there you can see off of 2, you're able to use the bottom lane pretty well and get momentum, but it's like the bottom works in turns 1 and 2. The high line works in 3 and 4, from what I can tell. And Rogers might get the advantage right here because he's got the bottom going here in 1 and 2. Let's see if he can get up closer to the 03. He does, but now here comes the big kicker, the bottom lane in 3 and 4, where it's a smaller section of racetrack. And it's going to slow him down just a little bit. As Galligan looks like he's pulling away from Washer as we speak. Back here, this looks like a battle for ninth. Tim Walsh trying to get cleared of Nathan Hudson in the 7. And also, he's going underneath Jessica Sheldon, but I think that's going to slow down Walsh's momentum. Actually, he's able to stay there, so I guess it depends on how you're driving the bottom lane. You can make it work in 3 and 4 if you know what you're doing. And I think Walsh might have figured it out. Now let's see if he can clear the 02 off of turn 4 or not. That's going to be the big question, and he does. So really, you might be able to make the bottom lane work if you're careful enough. Back up here, Rogers still not giving up on the 03, but keep in mind, pit stops will be a factor later in the race if this ends up into an all green flag race. As back here, Blaine Keyes trying to work underneath Nathan Hudson, and that would be for the 10th position. James McLeod trying to get by Blaine Keyes himself for the 11th spot, and they are three wide. This might not work, guys. As Michael Norman's up high. And now they settle it out pretty well. And now McLeod trying to give a bit of a draft to Blaine Keyes over Nathan Hudson for the 10th spot. And now here comes Blaine with the bottom run here in 1 and 2. Like I said, if you're in the bottom lane in 1 and 2, that's the place to go. But if you're in 3 and 4, you might be better off with the high line. But if you can make the low line work, then it's all good and well. And I think Blaine's going to be able to make it work and clear the 7 car. Tim Walsh, and this, what a familiar sight with these two. Tim Walsh trying to get by Trent Dunham for 7th, and these two have a long history in the NR offline community, going back to the days of the Snickers Cup Series for the NNSCRA. And now their rivalry transfers over here to see who is the best between the two. And so far, both guys have had pretty good consistent seasons. Trent being 2nd right now in the points, and Walsh in 10th. And they both have had phenomenal runs so far. And the interesting thing for Walsh, this is only his 2nd season in the Walmart Cup Series. And he's had... And he might as well, arguably, could be the most improved driver from last season heading into this season. Last season, he was in the number 45 for Everham Motorsports. This season, he's in the number 15 for Tweenix Racing, and he's battling old Trenty Poo. Up ahead, Carson Gumm in the 6th position, and Rogers is actually losing ground on Charles Sanford and is actually caught by Preston Plourd. And this is for the 4th spot, as Preston trying to get a higher spot so he can manage to gain a little bit more points on Johnny Gardner, the points leader. As up a front, Galligan's dominating this race and continues to pull ahead. Let's see, now Dunham is 7th. Where is Gardner on track? Back of the pack, last scored in 35th, so Gardner not having a good run, and he could end up losing the points lead this week, unless a miracle were to happen for him. And now here comes Preston Plourd with a run to the inside of Rogers. Let's see if Plourd can out-duel Rogers off of 4, or will Rogers maintain the high line? He does maintain the high line, but Plourd's still underneath. It's like Rogers' car, despite running well here in the top 5, he's just not really able to keep up with everybody. It's Preston Plourd still on the bottom. We'll see if he can get by him off of 4 or stay tucked in side by side. And it virtually stays the same. However, Rogers is actually going to stay clear of the 41. As meanwhile, here, Walsh and Dunham are still battling. And back here, two of the females of this series battling. And that was for the 9th spot. Stephanie Naylor gets cleared of Jessica Shelton. As Shelton is now getting caught by James McLeod. And speaking of McLeod, he's been on a bit of a momentum streak. He continues to get some good finishes. In fact, he moved up from 24th to 15th in points after last week at Pocono, finishing in the top 5. And right now, he's running 11th, so having a decent day today, as he's got a run underneath Shelton. But Shelton's going to be able to keep that high line going. As back here, Tim Walsh had a run on Trent Dunham, but now is caught by Stephanie Naylor in the 84. So right now, you're seeing a lot of those guys who are in between that 28th or 33rd spot in points having good runs. Chris Washer in 2nd, Zach Rogers 4th, Stephanie Naylor in 9th, Jessica Shelton in 10th. So the only ones that I think that aren't having a good run today right now are Kyle Matthews and Dylan Poteet. Matthews in 23rd, Poteet in 39th. He hasn't really been able to move up a whole lot in this race. Galligan leads the way and isn't going to clinch the most laps led bonus points for the day. And Galligan, this would be a huge help for him in points, because he's been free-falling big time in the standings lately. He fell out of the top 20 into 26. So if he were to win this race, this could really help him out a whole lot as far as getting back in the top 20, as he continues to pull away from Chris Washer in 2nd. And Preston Plourd does get around Zach Rogers. And Stephanie Naylor's actually gone by both Trent Dunham and Tim Walsh, as Sheldon and McLeod continue to battle for 10th. But McLeod is going to be clear of Sheldon, so officially clears him into 10th. Lurking in the shadows in 12th is Devin Becker. Blaine Keyes in here battling with Anthony McCrory. Chase Oliver in the 68 Barks car trying to make something work for himself, trying to work his way up into the top 15. As Preston Plord, Zach Rogers battle it out once again for 4th. Rogers wants to get that spot back. Let's see if Rogers can make it work. I don't think he's going to, however. As Galligan still leads away and leads by now almost 2.25 seconds over Chris Washer. Jessica Sheldon starting to free fall as here comes Devin Becker behind her for the 11th position. That would be the battle for 11th between Sheldon and Becker. And then we got a three-car battle right here for the 13th spot with Blaine Keyes, Anthony McCrory, Michael Norman. And then we got Hornet's Nest on back. Kyle Matthews actually trying to work his way up. Last scored in 19th. Keep this in mind, we have yet to have pit stops today. Yeah, we have yet to have pit stops, and you gotta wonder when will they pit, and they better hope that maybe a caution don't come out, so that way it doesn't mess the field grid up for a restart, in case the pit stops were to happen, as right now Walsh is underneath Dunham again. This time it's only for the 8th spot, as Naylor went by both of them a little while ago. And actually, Stephanie Naylor got cleared of Carson Gunn. Man, she's really been on a roll, gaining spot after spot after spot. It's like she has one of the fastest cars on a consistent run. As she now has caught Zach Rogers for the 5th position. And let's see if she can make the bottom lane stick underneath of Rogers. Looks like she might be able to, and now she's going to get that run into 1. Let's see if she can make it work again. Or will Rogers get the advantage this time around? No, Naylor gaining little by little on Rogers. So I give it a couple more laps and she could be clear of him very, very soon. As they're getting ready to come off of turn number 4, can she clear him? I think she did, so Naylor up to 4th. And now we got a battle for 3rd starting to brew. Preston Plord slowly gaining on Charles Sanford. And in turn, both of them are catching Chris Washer, in which Galligan continues to pull away. Man, he's just been domination city today. And Naylor is actually slowly catching up to the three cars ahead of Plord, Sanford, and Washer. So Naylor could find herself before the end of the race possibly in 2nd. So far, still no pit stops, though they were nearly 3 wide with Kyle Keefe, William Brock, and Austin LaPlante for a moment there, and that could have, if they weren't careful, that could have been a major problem. And now Stephanie Naylor has caught Preston Plord and is coming underneath for the fourth spot. However, she doesn't quite get the run right there, as it's now 11 laps to go here at Phoenix. And Naylor's got the run underneath once again. Charles Sanford now losing ground to Chris Washer. And now Naylor with the run on the bottom once again underneath of Plourd. And now we got a battle for sixth starting to brew. Zach Rogers has it, but Carson Gum wants it. And James McLeod actually goes by. Wait a minute. Wait just a moment. Oh, our first instance of pit stops is Trent Dunham's the only one that came in to pit road out of everybody. And now here comes Galligan. Galligan now is into pit road. Quite a few cars are staying out. And Stephanie Naylor stayed out and led that lap. So she did get cleared of Preston Plourd. Now it's only going to be a matter of time of like how the pit stops are going to turn out. As there's Galligan. We're going to watch Galligan's pit stop right here. Is he going two tires and gas or four tires and gas? Two tires and gas. And Washer gets out, though he scrapes Charles Sanford a little bit. Nothing major right there. As we continue to look around the field, and now Stephanie Naylor's into the pits, and I think she went with gas only. That could be helpful for her in the long run, but the caution is out. Caution flag is out. Oh, and we had a wreck, and it involved the points leader, Johnny Gardner. Oh, but now we get a secondary wreck. Oh, and no, man, this ain't going to end well. The track's going to get blocked. Cars might pile in. Oh, Galligan, you better watch out. I think he's going to be okay. Oh, no! Woo! Close call. Huge close call for Sean Galligan. He about nailed, I believe that was Angel Navarro in the 19. Holy cow, that was a close call. And now the complexity of this race has changed completely. So let's go ahead and take a look at the replay of what brought the caution out for the first time today here at Phoenix. Well, we're going to watch Devin Becker, Johnny Gardner right here. Devin Becker, I don't know what the deal was. He came up, but Gardner came down, and they just slammed into one another. I'm not sure. Maybe Becker thought he could get clear of Gardner, but didn't realize he had a run. I'm not entirely sure as to what happened right there, but they both did get the outside wall pretty good. But now we're going to get the secondary wreck right here where Gardner comes down into Pichu London. It forces him into William Brock, and they both pound the inside concrete wall, and they collect Angel Navarro and Austin LaPlante, in which Tanner Sullivan had nowhere to go. He just got blocked in by that whole ordeal. And we're actually going to go on board here slow motion with Sean Galligan, because I am curious, how in the world did he not hit Angel Navarro when he was coming off of turn number four here? Let's watch as Navarro's going up the track. Navarro realizes he's coming and he turns down just in time. Holy madness, that was just nuts. But anyways, let's go ahead and take you to the restart, if we do get a restart here at Phoenix. Well, after that caution, two cars out of the race, and they were Angel Navarro and Tanner Sullivan. Now, interesting scenario as a result of that caution. Sean Galligan is your leader, but he's going to be restarting in front of damaged machines or tail end of the lead lap cars. So the top 20 when we go back racing will be Sean Galligan, then second Chris Washer, third Preston Plourd, fourth Stephanie Naylor, fifth Zach Rogers. Sixth is now Kyle Matthews, seventh Tim Walsh, eighth James McLeod, ninth Chase Oliver, tenth Anthony Ritchie. Then it's Jesse Setti, John Cittadino, Joshua Collard, Blaine Keyes, James Qualls, Dylan Thoreau, Anthony McCreery, Katie Cochran, DJ Curtis, Austin Mongold. And then the rest of the cars that are in line properly are Matt McIntyre, PJ Williams, Kyle Keefe, and Johnny Gardner. Going back here to Galligan, so Galligan could have a challenge because he's going to have those guys that he was pulling away from right behind him. And now Galligan's going to probably get held up by Propichu London as Chris Washer tried to get the high lane going, but couldn't quite because of Austin LaPlante being up there. Next time by, it'll be two laps to go here at Phoenix, so... And now Washer is right on the back bumper of Galligan. He's going to do whatever he can to try to get to the lead. And this would be his second win this season, and I believe it would be his 14th overall in the history of his career in this series. But Washer's still got to deal with Pichu. Now he's going to manage to maybe get on by the 17. And whoa, three wide with LaPlante, Naylor, and Rogers. Maybe not a good idea. And now here comes Washer with a run to the inside as we come to take the white flag. White flag is out. Washer with a run on Galligan. Man, it's really congested up here. Oh man, this could end up being one of them photo finishes, because Galligan's going to get that run off of turn four on the high lane, possibly. Maybe not! What a turn of events! Off of turn four, Chris Washer wins the Subway Fresh Fit 400, at Phoenix. Last lap pass for the win. Wow! What a finish. Holy cow. Wow, the dominant car of the day comes up short here at Phoenix as Chris Washer with the last lap pass for the win is going to get his second win of the season, 14th overall in his career in Walmart Cup. Let's look at the rest results. Sean Galligan, you got to give props to him. He was the dominator of the day. He's going to come away, though, in second, but this is still going to be a fantastic points day for him. But, man, he wanted that win so bad. Preston Plourd, much-needed good finish in third. That's going to help him close in the gap on the points lead. Stephanie Naylor, the highest of the go-or-go-home drivers and highest rookie, finishing fourth. Second week in a row, highest finishing rookie in the field, I believe. So, great job for the 84 team. And then Zach Rogers, great run in the fifth position, so that could help him get into the top 30 in points, potentially. Same thing goes for Kyle Matthews, getting a good finish in sixth. Solid run for James McLeod in seventh. Tim Walsh with a great run in eighth. Anthony Ritchie, didn't really talk about him all day. He came out of nowhere and got a ninth place run. And then John Cittadino, great run in 10th, rounding out the top 10. Rest of the top 20 was Chase Oliver, Jesse Setti, Blaine Keyes, Joshua Collard, Dylan Thoreau, James Qualls, Katie Cochran, DJ Curtis, Anthony McCreery, and Matt McIntyre. Rest of the top 30 was PJ Williams, Austin Mongold, Johnny Gardner, Kyle Keefe, Charles Sanford, Carson Gum, Michael Norman, Trent Dunham, Nathan Hudson, Jessica Shelton. And then everybody that finished the race on the lead lap left were Dylan Young, Devin Becker, David Rivera, Dylan Poteet, Dorian Facepuncher, William Brock, Seth Cole, Dougie Shears. The next two cars finished a lap down, Pichu London, Austin LaPlante, and the other two cars were out of the race after our one and only caution that changed this race completely, Angel Navarro and Tanner Sullivan. That does it for our coverage here today at Phoenix. Next week, we head to Michigan, and that, my friends, is going to be exciting. But until then, here are your results, rookie points, and regular points heading into Michigan. And this is Levi McIntyre, signing off.